With Karunanidhi's death, Indian politics has lost another one among the last of its long marchers. Long marchers are people who were adults when India became independent. There were great names there. There was Balasaheb Thackeray, there was Harkrishan Singh Surjit, there was Jyoti Basu. All of them have gone, and now they've been joined by Karunanidhi. We are still left with some. We are left with Mr. Prakash Singh Badal, Mr. L.K. Advani. The important thing about these long marchers is not that they are perfect people. They all have many flaws. Karunanidhi had many flaws, including corruption. But they are fascinating people and in their own ways, great patriots who kept India together. Now, if you don't like Balasaheb Thackeray, you might be surprised that I am saying this about him. But politics is about agreeing or disagreeing, and you can disagree strongly with somebody's views. But the fact is that all these leaders commanded the loyalty and trust of a certain number of Indians, and then used that loyalty and trust to add to the larger national effort, strength, confidence, the belief in the Republic. To me, my two high points of my conversations with Karunanidhi: one, when he declared how he became a nationalist. I asked him quite gingerly, isn't it true that you were called a separatist in the 60s? He said, no, it's not correct. In fact, and he laughed, he said, I wasn't called a separatist, I was a secessionist. So I said, what changed your mind? And he said, what changed my mind was, our mind, that is in DMK, is the three wars, 62 against China, 65 against Pakistan, and then another one was coming up. And he said that when we debated the issue, we realized that Tamils by themselves cannot have sovereignty of their own. So if we Tamils want sovereignty, we have to share the larger sovereignty of a state called India. And that's how Indian democracy made a secessionist, a self-avowed secessionist, into a nationalist. Look at many such examples. Mr. Balasaheb Thackeray, a man who never even traveled to Delhi, who had enormous flaws. His people had a hand in the riots. He wasn't a nice guy in many ways. Yet, in his own funny way, he gave the city of Bombay and the state of Maharashtra stability. You look at Mr. Badal in Punjab. He endured the Bhindranwale phase. He kept his sanity, and he has then sort of shepherded Punjab back to normalcy. Again, you can vote for him or you can not vote for him. And similarly, Mr. Advani, today he has been put away as a mark darshak by the BJP. But the fact is that he founded the new BJP, and he also made the new BJP friendly enough for so many other allies to join it. And that's how he convinced India that coalition governments can survive, because his was the first coalition government headed by Mr. Vajpayee that completed its full term. So together, this brilliant cast of characters enriched Indian politics. One more of them has now gone, and I think we will miss him greatly, whether we liked him or not.